nothing to do. So they want to keep themselves occupied. They sit together, and the hadith states, فَتَآقَدْنَا وَتَآهَدْنَا أَلَّا يَكْتُمْنَا مِنْ أَخْبَارِ أَزْوَاجِهِنَّ شَيْئًا. The all 11 got together and they took an oath and promised that they will relate the true state, they will describe the true state of their husband without changing anything, without hiding anything. Now they begin, now you've had it. One of them says, you know, my husband, when he eats everything. And when he drinks everything. There's nothing left in the cup. Not a sip does he leave. And when it comes time to sleep, he doesn't want to know me. He goes to his own room, in his own bed, and locks the door. This is my husband. But my sisters are thinking, we have many like this in our houses. Another one says, you know, my husband is like the meat of a useless camel. And then this meat is on top of a mountain which cannot be reached or climbed. Basically what she was thinking, my husband is useless. And secondly, in spite that he's useless, he's impossible to approach. He makes it out that he's important. The third one says, what can I say about my husband? I've got nothing to say about him. I fear that if I begin to make a mention of him and his faults, I can continue all night and his faults will never end. Like this, you need to read up this yourself. It's in Sahih al-Bukhari. Like this, each and every woman began to describe the true state of her husband. Now the last woman to describe her husband, and Allah give us a wife like this to all of us, was Zarq. And this hadith has become famous and is known by her name, the hadith of Zarq. Now she begins to talk about her husband. She says, Abu Zarq, and how can I praise Abu Zarq, my husband? Anasa min huliyin uzunayya wa mala'a min shahmin adubayya. He made my ears bow with jewelry. Meaning that he gave me so much jewelry that my ears have begun to hang down because of all the jewelry that is on my ears. This is how much jewelry he gave me. وَمَلَعَ مِنْ شَحْمٍ أَدُضَيَّ. He made my thighs full of fat by feeding me. He gave me so much food that I am nice and round. And then she says, he kept me so happy, so content, that due to self-admiration, I began to feel that I was virtuous. وَجَدَنِي فِي أَحْلِ غَنِيمَةٍ. He found me in a very poor household, poor home, who possessed nothing. He took me out of this house, and he took me to a household which possessed everything. Horses, camels, goats, sheep, every single thing that you can think of. He took me from a poor house, and took me to this rich house. He says, فَإِنْدُهُ أَقُولْ فَلَا أُقَبَّ. I say what I want. He never criticizes me. He never scolds me. He never tells me off. He says, فَإِنْدُهُ أَقُولْ فَلَا أُقَبَّ. I say what I want. He never criticizes me. He never scolds me. He never tells me off. وَأَرْقُدْ فَأَتَصَبَّ. I sleep and I keep on sleeping. Late till the morning, nobody is allowed to wake me up. وَأَشْرَفْ فَأَتَخَمَّ. I eat and I drink so as much as I like. And even then, there is so much food that it all is spare. She says, this is my husband, Abu Zarq. After praising her husband, she begins to praise her mother-in-law. Where will you find a girl today that will praise her mother-in-law? She says, أُقُومُهَا رَضَاحْ وَبَيْتُهَا فَصَحْ. My mother-in-law, what can I say about my mother-in-law? Her utensils are always full, and her house is spacious. Meaning that my mother-in-law is very rich, and not a miser like the women of the time. Every time she's entertaining guests, she is giving them food, she is giving them drink. Like this, she praises every member of her in-laws, the son, the daughter, every member of that family. Then she says, finally, what happened one day was, one morning, while the utensils of milk were being churned, my husband Abu Zarq left the house in the morning He saw a beautiful woman sitting with two cheetah-like children playing with pomegranates. His eyes fell on this woman. He loved her so much that he married her and divorced me. She says, I then married another guy, a prince, who was a soldier at the same time, a chief of his tribe. And he gave me everything. Anything I asked for, he gave me. He gave me every type of wealth. And he said to me, eat as much as you please. Give to your mother and father as much as you please. She says, the fact of the matter is, if I add all his good qualities up, and everything that he gave me, it doesn't even add up to a little thing which Abu Zara had given me. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is relating this story to his wife, our mothers. After relating this story, he says to Aisha, O Aisha, I am to you as Abu Zar was to his wife, Ummi Zar. The difference is, O Aisha, I will not divorce you like Abu Zar divorced his wife. And our mother replies, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what comparison is this? You are more to me, billion times more to me than Abu Zar was to his wife, Ummi Zar. Only if we followed the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never in a billion years will there be a divorce in our houses. Will there be feuds in which families are destroyed if we were to live a life like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On top of this, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would help his wife doing their chores, the things that women normally do in their houses. He himself would milk the goat. He would fetch the firewood. He would mend his shoes. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would patch his own clothes. Today we men feel too proud to be doing these things. What will people say if they find out that we are doing these things in our houses? Suffering from pride, we consider these as being only womanly duties or womanly things. And if a woman didn't perform these duties, she would have to go to her father's house and we would divorce her. Yet the best of creation himself would do these things in his house. And he never considered these things to be things of low nature. And this is the example the Salafus Salihin, our elders, followed. Look at Sa'id ibn Amr. Sa'id ibn Amr was the governor of Hims, appointed by Umar Farooq himself. Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala wrote to the people of Hims. He write down the name of the fuqara, the poor people in Hims, so I can give them their due, allocate some money for them. Now they wrote down the name of the fuqara, and the first name that they wrote on this list was the name of their governor, Sa'id ibn Amr. When this list reaches Umar, Umar is surprised. So why have they written the name of their governor right on top of the list? They informed him, إِنَّهُ فَقِيرٌ لَأَنَّهُ يُنْفِقُ مَا لَدَيْهِ عَلَى الْمَسَاكِينَ. He is poor because everything he possesses, he donates to the fuqara. And he says, مَاذَا أَصْنَعْ وَكَدْ أَصْبَحْتُمْ فِي ثَلِكِ. What can I do? You have become my responsibility. Umar has burdened me. Umar has wasted me. Umar said to the people of Hims, I have not wasted him. I have been burdened with the responsibility by Allah, and I have burdened him with the responsibility, and I have appointed him as your governor. He asked them, tell me, how is this Sa'id ibn Amr with you? How does he treat you? Does he fulfill your rights and fulfill the responsibilities as a governor? They said, oh Umar, he's a very good governor. There are four things which we dislike with regards to him. One, he only comes out at the time of duha, forenoon. We don't see him before this. The second thing that we dislike is that we do not see him during the night. We only see him during the day. The third thing that we dislike is that one day every month he remains absent. We don't see him at all. And the fourth thing that we dislike is that he faints time after time. Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu sent a message and asked him with regards to these four things. The governor of Hims comes and says, O Umar, as with regards to my coming out only at the time of duha, forenoon, is because I have no servant to serve me. My wife is ill. She does not feel well. After Fajr, I begin to take care of her responsibilities. I do all the things in the home, all the things that my wife normally used to do. And I only finish at the time of duha. It is after this I come and meet the people and take care of their responsibilities. As for my coming out in the evening, as for my not coming out during the night, it's because I have left the day for the people and I have left the night to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as for my absence one day a month, O Umar, it is because I only possess one pair of clothes and that is the pair that I am wearing. And on that day, I take off this pair, I wash it, and I wait for it to dry. And then after this, I wear the same pair again. It is because of this I stay absent. And as for my fainting, it is because I remember the martyr, as a